Good morning. How are you? It's a lovely Sunday. At least I hope it is. This has been recorded on Thursday and it's a gorgeous day here. You know, one of the advantages of you worshipping at home is that you don't need to wear a mask. And I was speaking to a lady not so long ago and she said that she hoped that masks would become compulsory. And the reason for that was wearing a mask is a lot cheaper than having a facelift. So I'm sure no one in this congregation requires a facelift. Anyway, let us welcome to this service and let us worship God. We're delighted to welcome Rachel, who will be singing the first hymn, which is How Excellent in All the Earth. Said, I am the light of the world. While you have light, believe in the light, that ye may be children of light. Let us pray. O God, you are the source of light that never fades, and of the life that never ends. We lift our thoughts to you now, and long for your life to flow into our wearied hearts, and for your light to illumine our darkened minds. God of love, we come before you, penitent for our many sins and foolishness. We confess that we have wandered from your light, that we are afraid of our darkness. We have not made you a welcome guest in the inner sanctuary of our souls, and we have shut the door against your spirit. Father, we remember that you are a merciful God, and that you gave your Son to be Saviour of men. And as he did cleanse the temple built by men, cleanse now the sanctuary of our souls, drive out all evil thoughts and desires, and grant that we may be children of light through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us hear the word of God as it is contained in the book, the Old Testament, the book of Psalms, Psalm 137. And we will read the first six verses. By the rivers of Babylon we sat down and wept as we remembered Zion. On the willow trees there we hung up our lyres, for there those who had carried us captive asked us to sing them a song. Our captors called on us to be joyful. Sing us one of the songs of Zion. How could we sing the Lord's song in a foreign land? If I forget you, Jerusalem, may my right hand wither away. Let my tongue cling to the roof of my mouth if I do not remember you. If I do not set Jerusalem above my chief joy. Amen, and may God add his blessing to that reading from his word. What we're going to do now, Matthew is going to play a song by Boney M. And that actually is based on that reading, Psalm 137, by the rivers of Babylon. So, Matthew, take it away. Great, Matthew. Thank you very much for that. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I'm sure you enjoyed it at home. You know, Rachel was threatening to dance that while Matthew was playing. That would have been some sight, would it not? Anyway, why are we worshipping? Why do we come to church on a Sunday? Why are you worshipping in your own home here this morning? I think we've come to worship to be at one with God. We come to invite God into our lives. We come to feel his presence. We come to get our lives into focus once more. Some of us have perhaps come with worries and concerns. Some of us have come perhaps with what seems to us to be intractable problems. Some of us are worried about something that has happened in the past. Some of us are worried about the future. Some of us may be worried about our health or the health of loved ones. And when we think about what is happening in the world with COVID, with poverty, with global warming, with climate change, with man's inhumanity to man, with political conniving, with the melting of the glaciers and of polar ice caps, with terrorism, the list is almost endless. Then there is little wonder that many of us are intensely worried about what is happening to us and to our world. A lesson from Psalm 137 told of a group of exiles who had lost most of the things that sweet in life. They were bereft of liberty and home. They had to listen to the mockery of their enemies who compelled them to sing songs of faith. And how can they do this in the land of suffering and loss? It was the last thing they felt like doing. They found it hard to sing the Lord's song in this land of pain and grief. And you know, sometimes we feel like these Jewish exiles. When the storm clouds close in around us, when the sky darkens and sorrow and suffering and anxiety invade our lives, then it's no easy matter to sing the Lord's song. We find it difficult to profess our faith in God or even go to church. Of course, it's never been an easy matter for men and women to hold on to faith and prayer when tragedy strikes and times are hard. You know, one of the hardest trials we might be called upon to bear is to witness a dear one's pain and grief and to stand by feeling utterly helpless. I have sadly seen it happen many times, and it strikes us to the core of our being. How did Jesus react to this? How did he react to human pain and grief? How did he react when things went wrong, or when he came up against the wrongs of the world? One of the first things that we notice is that he was always positive in his reaction. He always did or tried to do something. He didn't wallow in speculation or self-pity. We are tempted to say, why me? What have I done to deserve this when things go wrong for us? I am not aware that Jesus went into the whys and wherefores at any time. He always acted positively. He always did something. I know that in many of the situations that concern us or beset us, there is little that we can do. But you know, we can pray. Prayer is vital to our way of life and to our well-being. Jesus found it so, and so do we. You no doubt, I love this story, you no doubt know the story of the Highlander. He was an atheist, and he was out in his wee boat in the Minch, and a severe storm blew up. And he did something he had never ever done in his life before. He knelt down in his boat and he prayed. And he said, "Oh God, if you get me out of this, I promise I'll never bother you again." I love that story. Now, I'm not suggesting that we should be like him, but it is important to unburden ourselves to God. Not for him to give an answer, it doesn't work like that, but for him to uphold us. And if the problem concerns a friend or local situation, then there is often something practical that we can do. Let us never forget that when God wants something done, he has to get a man or a woman to do it, and that someone might be you or me. One of the great facts which enables us to hold on to our faith, even when we are brought within the gambit of pain and sorrow, is the cross. And when we look at the cross of Jesus, we see not just a man hanging and suffering there. We see God himself taking on human pain and transforming it through love into the victory of a new life. God knows what we might be going through in our lives. He's been there. He came through it. And our faith enables us to do the same. The supreme lesson the cross demonstrates is that suffering and pain are not the end of the story. A new day will dawn. The exiles couldn't sing the Lord's song because they felt God had deserted them. And from their position of captivity, they could see no sign of his sovereign power at work. And possibly we might feel the same at times with the things that trouble us, with our world beset by seemingly insoluble problems, with millions starving and living in extreme poverty, with greed and violence that seem to be manifest all over. And of course, with COVID destroying the lives of so many people, how on earth can we sing the Lord's song? Jesus never gave up his faith. However dark the times might have been, however cruel and godless men might be, Jesus believed that God was working his purpose out. He went to Calvary believing in that, even when his mission seemed to be a failure. He had given his all. He had utterly spent himself for mankind. And yet he seemed to have so little influence. He was so misunderstood that his last hours were spent hanging in agony on a cross. Yet in spite of all that, he never lost his faith. And on that dark day when mankind went as far in wickedness as mankind could go, God was not absent. We are called upon to sing the Lord's song. Even in a land of great anxiety and suffering and perplexity and cruelty, we are called upon to sing it, however strange and hostile life might be. Our God is always with us. And because of that, because of what happened on the cross at Calvary, we can, with confidence, sing the Lord's song. Amen. May God add his blessing to these words spoken in his name. And we are now delighted to hear again from Rachel, who is going to sing a solo. Let us again unite our hearts in prayer. Let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, we pray that you will be with us now. Father, be real and near to each and every one of us. Father, we have come here this morning to be at one with you, to get our lives into focus once more. And perhaps we have come with things that trouble us, with problems, with anxieties, with worries. But Father, we have come to lay these things at your feet. We have come seeking peace, which we can only receive from you. Father, we thank you for so much. We thank you for the gift of life itself. We thank you for our health and strength. We thank you for our families, for our loved ones, for our neighbours, for our friends. We thank you for people. We thank you, Father, for the world in which we live and for the fact that we live at this time in history with the many benefits that are conferred upon us. And now, Father, we think of others. But we first of all pray for this world which you have made. We do not know your ultimate purpose for it, but we pray that we may not frustrate your intention through our selfishness or greed or ignorance. You have given us increasing knowledge of the world and more opportunities to use its resources as we think fit. May this make for the enrichment of life and not for its impoverishment. Father, we pray for mankind, and we think of all who this day are suffering, suffering through the greed of others, suffering as a result of war or violence, suffering from illness, but we especially think of those who are suffering from COVID. We think of the devastation that it has caused throughout the world to so many families. And Father, we pray that you will be with them all. And now, Father, we pray for those that we know who need your help in a special way. We think of those who are in hospital, those who are in despair, those who are lonely, those who have lost a loved one. And in the silence, we bring them to you. And we also, Father, pray for our own families, wherever they may be. Guard, guide, and watch over them. This we ask in Jesus' name, and in whose words we further pray together, saying, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We're now delighted again to welcome Rachel, who is going to sing the hymn 551, In Heavenly Love Abiding.
Thank you.
grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with you all and those whom you love this day and forevermore. Amen.